If you're looking for a sensor that will bring the physics of light to life, as well as ways to investigate natural phenomena like the apparent movement of the sun, look no further than PASCO's wireless light and color sensor. The light and color sensor comes with a coin cell battery installed and is ready to connect right out of the box. The light and color sensor actually combines several different sensors into a single unit that can be used with both SparkView and PASCO Capstone software. For today, I'm going to use SparkView, and I've already connected the sensor wirelessly, and from the SparkView screen, you can see that the ambient light sensor found at the back of the unit measures UV index, illuminance, irradiance, and solar PAR, or photosynthetically active radiation. The spotlight sensor found on the front of the unit can measure the levels of red, green, and blue light as a percentage of the total of all colors measured and total white level. While I'm connected, let's take a look at a couple quick investigations you can complete right out of the box. Once the light and color sensor is connected, you can see that we have a quick start experiment here we can select called color sensing. When I select this experiment, it brings up a bar meter display that measures the light intensity on the y-axis and red, green, and blue on the x-axis. I'm going to select start and slowly move the spotlight sensor over the red, green, and blue paper. As I do this, you will see the light intensity percentage of each color will correlate with the color I move over. The way we see color, we're actually seeing the color that is reflected from the surface while all the other colors are being absorbed. Now let's demo the ambient light sensor. One of the great features of this sensor is the ability to conduct remote logging. This feature allows you to record data into its internal memory while disconnected from the software. To demo this, I will start a new experiment and select remote logging. I'm going to select my light and color sensor, and I know this one is mine as each sensor has a 6-digit identifier that I can also see on the screen. The sensor defaults to a sample rate of 1 Hz. If I were doing an investigation that ran over a course of several hours, I may want to adjust to a slower sample rate. For example, let's say I want to make sure that I planted my tomatillo plants in an area of my yard that receives at least 6 hours of direct sunlight a day. I'm going to adjust my sample rate here to 5 minutes. Once I select OK, I will know that my sensor is in remote logging mode since the Bluetooth indicator light is now flashing amber. Yesterday, I placed this sensor in the area I currently keep my tomatillo plants so I can ensure they are getting the recommended amount of direct sunlight. And I set the sensor in remote data logging for approximately 12 hours. Now let's see how you can retrieve this data. I could wake up this sensor by briefly tapping on its power button, but instead I'm going to turn on this sensor that I used at home and choose remote logging. The software prompts you on which sensor you wish to connect and then will ask you how you wish to proceed. For this demo, I'm only going to download the data and then select the line graph display to give me a graph of illuminance over time. From this screen, I can analyze my data and see if my plants are indeed getting the recommended amount of direct sunlight during the day. And here you see I have a graph of illuminance over time. And this one's a little bit hard to interpret, so I'm going to show you another great feature. I can select time and shift the x-axis to show date and time. And from here, you can now see where I actually started my remote logging and when it ended. And at a quick glance, I can see my plants are getting just around 5 hours of direct sunlight a day, so maybe I should move them to a little bit different location. For more information on the wireless light and color sensor, as well as a library of experiments you can conduct with it, visit PASCO.com.